Hey, what's up guys? This is Sean. I always love to watch desk setup video on YouTube, but I realize most of the YouTubers who made their desk setup are full-time content creator. Their setup are amazing, but do not speak for everyone who don't have the use cases like video editing, podcasting, or like streaming, etc. So today, I'm super excited to show you guys the real productive workspace for a full-time software engineer. In this video, I'll be taking you through all the things I have on my desk and how they're working together. I have been using this setup for more than a year now, and I still love it. Hopefully, this video will give you guys some good inspirations and ideas as to what can be the best work from home setup for yourself. Besides, this setup has both Mac OS and Windows. I will talk about how I switched between these two operating systems later in the video. Without further ado, let's get started. First of all, the monitors, which I believe is the most important thing for productivity. On the left side is a 27-inch 2K display mounted with a single monitor arm. In the middle is an ultra-wide curved display with 3440x1440 resolution. On the top of it is the Logitech Brio 4K webcam for video conferencing. And on the right-hand side is another 27-inch 2K display positioned vertically. And these two monitors are mounted with a dual monitor arms. The reason why I need triple monitors is because I usually multitasking during my working hours. And I don't like keep switching between tabs and windows. I want to see everything. So here's the layout that I normally use. On the right side, I have a Slack open on top to communicate with my coworkers, with the emails and calendar open at the same time, so I can quickly check on any updates or upcoming meetings. On my main screen, I usually have my code editor on the right and the browser open on the left. Since I'm a front-end engineer, I need to see the application changes while I saved and compiled my code. On the very left, I usually have a few web pages open for either reading some engineering documents or search Slack Overflow if I encounter some technical difficulties. Under the main screen, I installed a desk shelf. I put some small decorations to bring some energy to this setup. In the middle, there's a soundbar, which is like 80 bucks from Amazon. The sound quality, it's okay, it's good enough for me. And on the right side is a wireless charger, which I used for charge my AirPod and my iPhone. My cat also loves to stay on top of the shelf while I am working. And guess what? She sheds sometimes and I need to clean those hairs since it's quite obvious on the black setup. The good thing about this shelf is it can hide my gaming keyboard and mouse if I'm not using it. The keyboard and mouse are offline Alienware. The best feature I love for the keyboard is it has a scrolling wheel for volume control, which is a big lifesaver. These mechanical keyboard plus gaming mouse setup are only for my Windows system for gaming purpose. The PC tower is also from Alienware. I bought a heavy duty PC mount to mount this under my standing desk so I can have a cleaner desk surface. Next, let's talk about the machine I'm using for my day-to-day work, my MacBook Pro. I put the laptop vertically to save some space, and a small tip here, making sure you put your Mac upside down so the ventilation is not blocked to avoid overheating. On the right top corner of my desk, there is a clock to help me track the time, an extra power outlet if I want to charge up something quick, a USB-C hub which establishes the connection between my MacBook Pro and all those monitors and other peripherals. When I'm using Mac, I use this wireless Magic Keyboard and trackpad combination. I like trackpad over the mouse because it's very nice for smooth scrolling and zooming. Since I'm so get used to the keyboard plus trackpad combination on the MacBook Pro, I wanted to replicate the experience with a wireless setup. Addition to that, I don't like to put keyboard and trackpad side by side. It's less efficient since I need to move my right hand between the keyboard and trackpad while navigating and typing, which has hurt my productivity. So I found a great keyboard and trackpad tray to put these two together. And when I'm not using my Mac, I can put these two away as a whole, not one by one, which is quite convenient. Let me know in the comment if you want me to do a full review of this tray. Okay, so the last topic you might be interested in is how do I switch between the Mac OS and the Windows system? Activating Mac, it's simple. I just press any button on my Magic Keyboard or trackpad. Then, if I wanted to switch to Windows, I put my Mac on sleep mode and turn on my PC. The monitor will automatically pick up the last active video income source and show the Windows system. And that's it. If you wanted to switch from Windows to Mac OS, you can use the similar approach, but the other way around. That's pretty much about this video. If you found this helpful, remember to like and subscribe to the channel for more video like this. Let me know in the comment section about your thoughts and anything you wanted me to dive deep into it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.